Hi guys, welcome to Third Style Garage. My name is Doug. Today's project is a 2003 Volkswagen Jetta TDI, very similar, 99.5 through 2003 with ALH engine. We're having hard starting issues. We've got a battery in it that's the correct one for the car, bought from the dealership, less than 2 years old. Pretty sure that's not the issue. We put a new starter in it just a couple months ago. I'm pretty sure that's not the issue. We are dealing with really cold weather. So those are the factors that are stacked against us. We also are pretty sure the alternator is good because the car resting with a fully charged battery is 12.2, 12.4 somewhere volts. And when we start up the car, the voltage jumps up to 14.2, 14.4. So that leads me to believe that the alternator is pretty good. Still having a really hard time starting, particularly in really cold weather. Here in Michigan, we've had some nights where it's gotten down to single digits. It's my son's car. He works night shift. It will start here in the evening. He'll get to work and it won't start when the shift gets out, which is a problem. Our theory is that the glow plugs, the harness, either the harness isn't working or it's got some bad glow plugs. We did hook up computer to it with a VAGCOM cable, VCDS software to try to diagnose it, but we've got a problem that there's communication error and it won't tell us what engine codes it's throwing. So that takes that diagnostic tool out. What we're gonna do is pull the glow plugs out and try to verify if they're working or not. If you're willing, give the video a thumbs up, hit the subscribe button, but stick around, let's see what we learn. If you don't have one of these tools for working on Volkswagens, they are incredibly handy. Simply put it on, locks into place. You can pull these hose clamps off. We really don't have to remove this snorkel tube, but what I want to do is unplug the coolant temp sensor that is behind the vacuum pump. That will allow, when I turn the keys on the car, the glow plugs will stay on for 45 seconds as opposed to just the few seconds that the glow plugs usually come on for. So this right here is the vacuum pump. To the right of it are the three glow plugs that go into the coolant. Directly below and behind those is a little D-shaped electrical plug that you can simply squeeze and pull, and that will unplug the coolant temp sensor. So the coolant temp sensor is, where did it go? This guy right here. Unplugged it from right below. So if you look at this coolant line that goes right into this housing, it goes directly out the back of that. So you simply want to unplug that guy. And then this black plastic bar that goes across here, and you see there's a wire coming out the back, is the harness for the glow plug. So you've got 1, 2, 3, 4 glow plugs that all should come on at the same time. So it is brittle, so be careful. I'm gonna gently work on pulling that off and then try to snake it out so that I can test it and the glow plugs. Here's the glow plug harness. I have it out. You can see the ends of these have broken off a little bit. You can see a little bit of the plastic remaining on the glow plugs. That one's pretty clean. That one's pretty clean. I already picked the pieces off. That one, you can see there's little bits of plastic left.
these harnesses get really, really brittle over time. So it's just important to be super, super gentle with it. Now I'm going to take a can of brake clean and I'm just going to liberally spray into this area, because I want to kind of hose away any dust. So when I pull the glow plugs out, dirt doesn't fall into the chamber. All right, so I took out glow plug number one. Here's how I'm gonna bench test it. Got a 12 volt battery charger here. Take your negative terminal, clamp it on the body of the glow plug, and then you can see there's a little black insulator here, and the top part is the positive terminal. Just gonna take this, clamp it on. It might spark just a touch, and we're gonna watch the end of it. And it starts to glow. It is a plug that glows. I wonder how they got, why they call it a glow plug. All right, this is the one that is my most passenger side. So we're gonna call that one good. Okay, so here's how I'm gonna test it. I took a file and filed down a little bit off of this vacuum pump housing. I have the wiring harness out here. I have a known good glow plug that was bench tested. Plugged it in there, have it resting against the ground. I have the coolant temp sensor unplugged, which will allow the glow plugs to stay on for the maximum time. And now I'm gonna go turn the key on and watch that spot right there and see if it glows orange. Turned it on. And it is glowing orange, which makes me believe that this wiring harness is good. Now I'm gonna do the exact same test in all four of the harness spots here, 1, 2, 3, 4, so I can verify all of them. But it's the exact same process, so you don't need to watch that. That would be boring. Good news and bad news. All four of my glow plugs worked great. They worked good in all four of the housings, which means that my starting, good news is my glow plugs and my housing worked. The bad news is that wasn't the problem with my starting. So I need to continue to evaluate that, but at least now you know how to check yours and verify whether they're working or not and which ones might need to be replaced. So getting this harness back in, again, be very, very careful with it. I unplugged the hose from my vacuum reservoir here. And I think the easiest gentle way to do it is to go in and have the harness upside down and then slowly just keep working it around all of the injection lines. And you just gotta keep gently sneaking it through there so you don't crack it. Put it back together. Good luck.